Hello children, welcome to our next poem of Standard 9 and it is Rain on the Roof, written by Coates Kenny, and he is an American lawyer and is a poet as well, a famous poet. Here he is talking about the rain on the roof. Generally we have some of the poems going with a particular season and we talk about the rain, the wind as we had in the previous poem. But here he is talking about the rain on the roof. The sounds and every sound is related with some or the other experience. He is remembering as the drops are falling onto his roof. He is remembering one or the other incidences. Sometimes he remembers his mother and what his mother does. Those all feelings come at that time. In the other stanza he remembers. Here in this particular session we are having only three stanzas. Actually, this poem is of five stanzas. In the next two stanzas, he remembers his sister, whom he lost after in a very young age, and he remembers his brother also. In the third stanza, he remembers his mother. Then the sister and brothers, they have removed in the syllabus. We don't have in the syllabus. This is how, with every raindrop which is onto his roof, he is remembering something, and every drop, remembering of mother, along with the mother, all the things related to her, everything, those emotions he is remembering, right from his childhood till whatever the age he is into, he remembers those and he says, what a lovely feeling. And when the rain comes, generally what happens, we stay back in our houses. And we want to enjoy the rain, that cold breeze we want to enjoy. We stay back in our houses. And how nice it looks when we have our cozy blankets and we want to have a soft pillow and sleep onto that one and dream, go off into our dreams. it is such a nice experience. The same way here, he is in that conditions and he is trying to, like when we are into our beds, lazily sleeping, happy breeze going on and the raindrops falling onto your roofs. Everything is bringing in thought for you. It is making you remember something, and some thoughts are coming into your brain. You are enjoying those thoughts. This is what he has written, his experience here. So let us start the poem. When the humid shadows hover over all the starry spheres, and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears. What a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. See, this is first one. When the rainy season starts, it's about to rain. We have the dark shadows coming and it is hovering. What is hovering? Continuously moving. Like we see the honeybees are hovering near the beehives. They're just hovering and they're only at a stable place and they keep on moving, and like it is, that is known as your hovering. The clouds also. And here it is the humid shadows. Humid with lots of water or moisture. The clouds are moving. They're dark. They're like shadows in the sky. And they're just hovering in your place. In that particular area where the rain has to come. So the humid shadows are hovering all over the sky, over the starry spheres. And you have the starry spheres, it is the stars and the sky. The whole sky is with good stars, and at that time the clouds have come there. And the melancholy darkness, generally when we have darkness or some, it is night, a sadness comes. We compare the sadness with the darkness. But still, this melancholy is sadness. So, but in spite of that sadness, in spite of that darkness, something this hovering goes on, the clouds are moving, it's bringing you happiness also. We are very happy to have the rains. Gently weeps in rainy tears. And we say, ki aasman rone laga hai. It's weeping and the tears are coming, the droplets are coming down. Gently the rain started coming down, the tears started coming, rolling down, and they are falling onto my roof. What a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of a soft rain overhead. What a bliss, what a happiness. I just want to hold my soft pillow and lie lazily onto my bed and my chamber, that is a small, whatever the room he is into, the cottage chamber bed. Just lie down and keep on listening to the raindrops falling onto your roof. Good. The next paragraph says, every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart and a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. And a thousand recollections weave their air threads into hooves as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof. Every tinkle, tinkle is a kind of sound. It's tip tip when it falls onto. The tinkle is a sound. Every tinkle, every drop is making a sound and onto the shingles. What is shingle? Generally, it is a group of scattered pebbles on the seashore. But here the reference goes on with, we have small tiles being laid onto the roofs, olden days roofs. And they are the slant ones. And we have the tiles in this way, small tiles they are laying. And it is in mud color, like brick color. And on that, when the water falls, you have a different kind of sound coming, the pitter-patter sounds coming. We always refer the raindrops in a pitter-patter way. So nowadays we are not able to listen because we have the cemented roof, so that pitter-patter sound and different kind of your sounds are not heard. But this is the little older days one. So that patter sound comes onto the roof, shingles. Has an echo in the heart. Every drop, tinkle, it is making a sound and there is an echo in the heart. Yeah, I'm remembering something. Every drop is bringing some thoughts to my mind. I'm remembering something or the other. And thousands of dreamy fancies. It is continuously, there is a flow of dreams. Because I'm lazily lying on my bed and continuously I'm having the dreams, fancies coming. Continuously there is a flow of. I'm not going away with one particular dream and trying to end the dream. And it is like endless thoughts just coming onto my brain. Into busy being start. And a thousand recollections weave like air threads into hooves. Weave. What is this weave? Weaving. We go with the cloth weaving. How are these cloths weaved or woven? They are like, the first row is kept in this and we have a crisscross being done, then the whole pattern of your cloth is being made. Even my thoughts are coming in life, it is pouring into my brain and the weaving part is going on. Every crisscross and mixture of dreams I have in my brain. As I listen to the patter, patter again is a sound, pitter patter is a sound. I listen to each of the drop and the patter of the rain. Every patter is bringing the dream. Is bringing the thought and everything is getting crisscrossed. I'm very happy with all these thoughts coming and I'm very happy in relating every drop with every dream. Come to the third stanza. Now in memory comes my mother. Till now he did not give any clear demarcation to what kind of thoughts he is getting. Here he is saying it is the first one whom I remember when it is rains and all, it is my mother. And in my childhood, how she used to be and later on how she used to be, I remember all those things along with each drop of the rain. Now in memory comes my mother, as she used in years agone to regard the darling dreamers, ere she left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. Now in memory comes my mother. And how is that? In years gone. It is now at present I am a grown up, I am a youth person and I am remembering my mother when I was a child and years before how she used to look and how fond she was of me and she used to take care of me. As she used to in years agone, before how she used to look, how she used to behave, now I am remembering them. To regard the darling dreamers, generally we see the mothers, they are so very loving and caring and when the child sleeps, they come, they cover the blanket, they make us a little more comfortable, they bend onto us, they kiss us and they make us comfortable and they love us at that time so and we can see that love in their eyes. I can see that face of my mother when she is bending onto me and she is comforting me. And when the mother goes away from there, the child goes off into his dreams. This is the darling dreamers. She want to leave the child into his dreams so that he can have his happy sleep, and she comforts and moves from there. I remember that face which is coming onto her, onto me, and I'm seeing how lovely that face is and how nice and how much of love that face is having. And that face is showing how fond of she is of me. To regard to the darling dreamers, era she left them till the dawn, and she does not disturb. And dawn, dusk and dawn, dawn is the daybreak and dusk is the last ray of your sun time. So dawn, till it is the morning time, she is not going to disturb us. Oh, I feel her fond look on me. The way she looks on me, I am feeling that pleasure now when the rains are coming and they are onto my roofs. As I list to this refrain, I list is listen. Continuously I am listening to this refrain. Refrain is a something repeated in a poem or a song. And here the repetition is the patter, patter sound. Continuously you are listening and refrain. So he says, as I listen to this refrain, the patters I am listening to, which is played upon my shingles by the patters of the rain. And every song like it is continuously the patters are onto my shingles. And because of this rain, I could remember my mother and that nice feeling I could get today. And I'm so happy to have my rains on my roof and remember my mother today. So this comes to an end of your poem. Thank you.